देव बरी सांस देव
तुमका ए दिन
तुमका दिन
या
तुमका ए दिन
वाइ यस्टरडे वी डिड प्रोनाउंस थ्री दैट मींस थर्ड पर्सन वी डिड एंड इट्स ऑल फॉर्म्स वी लर्न्ड दिस आर द फॉर्म्स वी लर्न्ड यस्टरडे हाँ आमी तू तुमी वी न्यू दिस फ्रॉम दैट वी मेड माका अमका तुका तुमका and all these forms we have done yesterday and then we read the sentences how those words are applied in sentences then we did third person and its forms all these forms yesterday we did then these ho he he jo ji je their forms kon kite apun reflexive pronoun and we did all this we did yesterday exercise okay any doubts here otherwise I will proceed to a new topic okay if you have no new questions I will go for the new topic Today we shall take nouns. So in my book, the lessons will be in this form. Every lesson will have thing. You will get a glimpse of how my book will look like. There will be a heading, and there will be teaching units. What we are going to learn in this lesson. First, gender of nouns we are going to learn. Second, singular and plural. Third, oblique forms. Fourth, case suffixes. And fifth, intransitive verb as, meaning be. These five, we learn other things also, but these are the main five points we are going to learn in this lesson. Now, read the following, not the text, read the following text. Okay, let me read for you to get the correct pronunciation. How Edwin Culasso. How Edwin Culasso. I am Edwin Culasso. That is C. Cedilla. This is the Portuguese way of writing. Without those who do not know, they will say Colaco. It is not Colaco, it is Culasso. How Edwin Culasso hai mujhe put English you can read for yourself I'm not going to read hai mujhe put ho mazo malgado put malgado eldest This word for you. Wadlo put also you can say.
Okay.
Yes. Mazo eklo put dotorki shikta. Dotorki, new word for you. But meaning is given here in English. Mazo eklo put dotorki shikta. दूसरो पुत इंजीनियर की करता दूसरो पुत इंजीनियर की करता इंजीनियरिंग तीसरो पुत आई शुड हैव रिटन हियर इज अंडरस्टूड बट बेटर टू पुट तीसरो पुत शेती शिकता The third one is studying agriculture. Or you can say third son. Third son is studying agriculture.
Father?
Yes.
Eklo put means the first what? Mazo eklo put dotor.
It could mean first one. It could mean one.
Huh. Okay, both.
It has got two meanings.
ओके
माका तेगी दुवो ओ हियर माका तेगी दुवो तेगी बिकॉज दिस आर फेमिनिन प्लूरल देयरफॉर दिस फेमिनिन प्लूरल फॉर्म कम्स तेगी but you can say maka tag put but maka tegi duo next poili madr dusri teacher ani tisri ma karta madr new word nun teacher english word teacher only तीसरी एम ए करता आउ अनि मुझी घरकारन हेलेन शेतकारा न्यू वर्ड्स आर कमिंग आउट हियर मुझी घरकारन माय वाइफ घरकार यू हैव लर्न द वर्ड घरकार दिस इज घरकारन Helen Shatkara farmers Ami Shatant yes
is it necessary to give name Helen after the corn
no but no then no because he has said his name no
yes sir
I with the speaker has introduced himself here as Edwin Kulaso Therefore, he only said there's no need, but he says he wants to introduce right. his wife to right. somebody. Therefore, he said, "Maji karkan shatkara."
So, father, this is like a paragraph about a person telling about his.
Yes, he's narrating.
All are related.
Yeah, okay. all are related. The center. He's gone narrating about himself and about his what he's doing.
Okay, thank you, father.
See. If you write a complete paragraph as a paragraph, then what happens? This all become confusion because I have to give Konkani text and English, correct? Therefore, I'm yes, giving father. One below the other.
Okay, father.
Father, is gharkarn the only word for wife?
Na bhai na sani.
Okay. Thank you.
It's a too popular. This would be a much more respectable word.
Okay.
Gharkarn.
Okay. Thank you.
Helen Shatkara, because farmers plural. If there is one Shatkar for a man, Shatkar, Shatkara. Ami Shatant, Bhat, new word. Ani Bhajyo Laita.
Father, what does Shetant mean?
Okay, in the field.
Okay.
I can put. We grow in the field. I can put.
Father, bhat is paddy, not rice, no?
No, paddy.
What is the word for rice?
Tandur.
Okay. Thank you.
But we Konkani we don't say Ami Shetant Tandur laita. No.
Father, sheet.
Shet, not sheet, shatan, shet.
No, sheet, no. sheet for rice.
That is for rice.
Oh, okay.
See, my whole concern is on Konkani. The English translation is a not literal translation because there are different ways of saying. Konkani speakers think differently and speak differently. From English speaking people. English doesn't, they think differently and expressions are different. So it is not exact translation. See here, laita means planting. Lai means plant in Konkani. Laita means we are planting. But in English we say we grow. Okay? So somebody can who is really good, whose mother tongue is English, can help me also to have a better English translation. I am open for that. But my whole concern is this, and to give you a rough translation in English, not a word to word translation. No. Amger gayo mashi bokdyo kunkda. This is a new word. Asat. Kunkda, fowls. That could be hen and as well as rooster, both mix. And even small chicken, all mix. Kunkda, pluralities.
Doctor.
Yes.
Kunkda is a Portuguese word.
No, Konkani word. We have in the world Konkani here.
Okay, they were good.
Yes.
Father.
Yes.
Bokri. Bokri can be called she goat. Bokri.
No.
Father.
No. Yes. Bokri is the she goat. And this is bokri, plural. Therefore, she goats. Yes. What is the question, madam? There.
Hello, father.
Yes.
Hello, father.
Yeah, don't say, go on, don't say hello, hello. Go on, ask your question, please.
Hello, father.
Yes.
Kunkda is a cock.
What happened?
Common word for cock and hen together.
Yes, and also chickens. Kunkard is singular.
Yeah. But
most of the time it is used in plural because they're all mixed ones.
Oh, yes, father.
Yeah.
This father, what is male buffalo?
Pardon?
Male buffalo. Moshi is female buffalo, no?
Where?
Moshi. Amger gayo.
Mashi.
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 Yeah, what is the other gender of Mashi?
Gender?
Yeah.
Like red dog.
Okay.
He buffalo.
Okay.
Okay. Up to now, the speaker, who Edwin Culasso narrated. Now, someone asking him, Tumgir, Kombio Kitlio, Ani Kombe Kitle. Edwin Culasso was speaking to this man. There is no name for this man. So, this person is asking him, Tumgir, Kombio Kitlio, Ani Kombe Kitle. Kombio plural. Therefore, this is kitlio. Kombe is plural. Therefore, kitle, plural. Then Edwin replies, Dha kombio. Ani don kombe asat. There is no need to say asat. If it just answers Dha kombio, ani don kombe, understood in Konkani. But just because I'm teaching you the verb as and its form, therefore I'm giving this form, asat. Bokdyo kitlyo asat. Bokdyo kitlyo asat. Then he replies, at asat. Then the person asking question, Pade Bokade Nant. See, this is the another word for you. He goats. Bokdyo, she goats. Bokade, he goats. Because singular would be Bokado. Then he answers, Pade Nant. Poon, this is a new word for you, but don bokade asat. Padenant, poon, दोन बोकडे असा. Then,
Father,
yes.
What is pade? Pade.
See, look, madam, in the meaning which I given in the bracket.
Yes.
Sorry. Wait. No. Sorry, I have to put here this one. Pade books. Singular pado.
No, but okay. What is the meaning of pade?
I told you, bulls.
Bulls, okay.
Yeah. Oh,
sorry, I didn't catch it.
Can you see this, my screen? Madam, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Please see the screen. Because okay. you should see the text which I am presenting.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Father.
Yes. Bokdancho, then that person asking, Bokdancho rang kaslo. Bokdancho. Look at this spelling clearly now. Because afterward there is some other word comes very, very close to this. Bokdancho. Rang, this is the new word. Kala. Kaslo. Then Edwin answers, Ek kalo. That means one goat is of black color. Ani dusro. Misled rangacho. Misled. Mixed. This is the new word for you. Rangacho. Now look at this word and this word. This is bokadancho and this is bokadancho. This is the difference is only this vowel. The one vowel, closed vowel, makes it she goats and this makes male goats or he goats. This is bokadancho and this is bokadancho. Get it? This very clear in my writing system. In traditional system, you don't know whether this or this. They write the same. But here, no. With this, you know. Just this word, you know, this refers to she goats. And this refers to he goats. Bokdancho rang kaslo. Then the answers, Ants Kalyo. Ani. And Teen Misal Rangancho.
Rangancho.
Because there are three colors, no? Therefore, they become Rangancho. Why Rangancho? Bokdyo is feminine plural. Therefore, this becomes feminine plural. Panch kalyo ani teen misal rangancho. Now this is a dialogue. This is a while speaking. These are not just statements. In a dialogue, how Konkani dialogue takes place. Now there is no need to say panch kalyo bokryo ani teen misal rangancho bokryo. No need, because here is asked here bokdancho rang kaslo. So this answer is enough. Then the person is asking, Batka kitli asad. This is a new word for you. Batka. Ducks. If there is one badak, comes Batka.
Dutur?
Yes.
Batka. Hains.
Batka.
Hains.
No, not exactly. They're different. Badak, that is swan. What are you saying? Hines is a swan. We don't have swans here in Goa. Maybe that's at Valpoi side, they might come. They are wild ones. They might come. But what we rear at home are batka, ducks. Ye kuch dave badak kasa. Look at the word badak. This is batka, but if the one badak, ye kuch dave badak kasa. We have only one, ye kuch. Means only one. Ye kuch means only one. Dave badak kasa, white duck. Then the person asks, tantiya tumi kiten kartat? Tantiya, plural. Tanti, tantiya, in the standard Konkani. Then he says, thodi, thodi, ami khatam. Ani urlali viktam. Thodi refers to tantya. Thodi ami khatam. Ani urlali, the rest, viktam. Then he asks the question, tumge alanche rook gadanant rook refers to tree and dhar refers to plant, but some people mix up both these. They say Ambachan zhaad, when it is a small one, when it is become big one, it is a rook. Rook and zhaad, there is a difference. Then he answers, maad. Spelling wrong here. Maad. Ambachan. पणसाचे चिकवाचे पपायाचे रूक म्हणजे आंब्याचे रूक पणसाचे रूक चिकवाचे रूक पपायाचे रूक. वी डोंट से माडाचे रूक. नो, माड मीन्स कोकोनट ट्री. वी डोंट से माड रूक माडाचे रूक. वी डोंट से, but we say आंब्याचे रूप, पणसाचे रूप, चिकवाचे रूप, if it's a grown up, आणि पपायाचे रूप. Then काजी, कॅश्यू, केळी, बनाना, पेरी, गोवा, आणि आंतेरी असत. Moment we say काजी, that means काजू tree. Keli means banana tree. Peri means guava tree.
Pear.
Yes, pear. The plural of this is peri. Very good. You remember. That means you have
Father, for coconut tree, instead of maad, can we use the word narl and narlyache roop?
No. Maad. For us, maad means coconut tree.
Okay.
Yes.
Father, what is chikwache? Chikwache.
Sapota.
Sapota is what?
Anna, what can I tell you? No, sapota. Chiku. It's an English sapota.
Chiku.
Chiku is an Indian word we are using. It is in English, it's called sapota.
Okay. Thank you.
Some people say chikuche, huh? But this is the Konkani form. Chiku become chikwa. Like natu becomes natwa. This is the Konkani form. Chikwache. Rook. Asa. Then that person says, Tumi Ajun. This is a new word. Ajun means still. Kheti, farming. Karta. Ani veveglyo. This is the new word for you. Different. Veveglyo means different. Monzati, new word. Animals. Ti monzat, tyo monzati. Therefore it becomes veveglyo monzati. Postat, rearing. Dekun, therefore. Tumka maji parbi. He's congratulating them because Helen and his, sorry, Edwin and his wife Helen are still continue to do farming and rearing animals. Then, because he said this, Edwin says, Tum kai diyo parayin karu, because he congratulated, no, to Edwin and to his wife. Therefore, he said, Tum kai diyo parayin karu. Now, how to say this one, Tum kai in English? Very difficult to translate. Literally, it means, you too, thank you. But I put, we too, thank you. He's thanking them. Edwin is thanking the man who had come to meet him. Then that man says, whoever had come, man or woman, we don't know, whoever speaking, could be a woman also. Vachu neta. Bye. Literally it means, I go and come back. But this is the way in Konkani it said, vachu neta. Then Edwin says, Vachun Eya, go and come back, literally. But in English, bye. Oh, goodbye. Whatever.
Father?
Yes.
Sometimes they can also say, Dev Bore Korun Tuka, no?
Yes. Dev Bore Korun Tuka, yes.
Instead of saying, Tumkain Dev Bore Korun?
No, Tumkain Dev Bore Korun, because he is replying to this man, no, this man, what did he, what did that whoever visitor came, he congratulated, no?
Yeah.
Tumka maji par bhi. So he, Edwin cannot say, Tumkai maji par bhi, cannot say, he's thanking him.
No. Yes, Father, but can he not reply, Dev Bore Korun Tuka?
He can say, Dev Bore Korun Tumka. He can say that.
Tumka.
He can say that. But this is another way of saying, Tumkai Dev Bore Korun.
Okay.
Suppose I say to you, Dev Bore Korun, then you are supposed to reply, Tumkai Dev Bore Korun.
I see. Okay, thank you.
Or if you are so close to me, then you will say, Tukai Dev Bore Korun. Different forms of Konkani which are there, I'm using. Now,
Father, what is animal in singular form?
Of? Singular
animal,
form?
Animal.
Mon zat. See, after N, there is apostrophe because it is not mon zati. It is not nasalization. This N has to be pronounced like N. Monzati, singular is Monzat. And plural is
Father,
Monzati.
It's Mon or Mon?
Mo. Not Ma. Mo. See, in my system, it cannot be Ma. It comes from the word Monizat, that which is dumb, which doesn't speak.
Okay,
Zat
okay.
Is kind. Monzati means the dumb kind, which doesn't speak. That is the etymology of this word. There are two words and became a compound word in Konkani. Monzati.
Doctor,
yes.
Doctor, monzati and zonwara with a difference kire.
Kainsi na. Te zanwar pun ti monzat. Both means animal. Zanwar if you use, it should be zanwara. And monzat if you use, its plural is monzati, because monzat is feminine. Its grammatical gender is feminine.
Father, in Konkani, is there any difference between wild and domestic something, or just animals? It is
no, that is. The reared animals, which is a postlely monzat. And the wild is ranvati.
Okay, Father.
Yeah. So this is how, when the book, my book will come, it will look like this. There will be a lesson first like this, either descriptive or a dialogue. In this particular is a dialogue. And then the grammar points come.
Father, your book is underprint or something like that?
What underprint, man? My goodness, might still I'm preparing.
Okay, Father.
Okay, I'm under still preparation. It takes to write one lesson, it takes me minimum 3 days.
You have any target, Father, when it will be finished? No.
Target, no. What to do? I have only one head, two hands and one brain. If I had many, I would have finished maybe within one day, no?
Yes, Father, correct.
So I have to work alone.
Right.
A lot of time is needed to reflect, to select words.
Absolutely.
The right constructions, checking sometimes different this one for its grammatical gender, whether it's correct. Some I know, but sometimes I have to check to make sure. Anyhow, now we'll go to grammar points. So what grammar points we are going to learn here now? Singular, plural and oblique forms of nouns and case suffixes. What are all these? Don't worry, we'll learn now. Now here, Konkani nouns could be classified into three genders, namely masculine. If I put M, that means masculine. Feminine, F. And neuter, NT. So when I write NT, that means it is neuter gender. And when I write F, it means it is a feminine gender. And when I write M, it means masculine gender. So this you have to remember. The nominative forms. Yesterday I was talking about nominative form, means you cannot reduce that form. Like you take a mad, spelling is M-A-double-D. You cannot remove anything from it. If you remove, it will be something, either it is a different word altogether or it will be a meaningless word. The nominative forms, it is also called direct forms, in a sentence remain unchanged. It remains as it is. The other forms, there are other forms of nouns are derived by adding endings or suffixes. Something you have to add to the nominative form. Endings, the technical term is suffixes. Okay, these suffixes are added to the oblique forms. To the oblique forms. I will come to that. What is the oblique form and all? Then you will learn. This is the just explanation first. Oblique forms. For example, see here now. Here itself I am explaining. For example, the noun put. The pooth is a nominative form. Correct? Any doubt? Pooth is a nominative form. You cannot remove any one letter, you cannot remove from this. If you remove, it means something else. So pooth is the nominative form. Has putta, and we put dash as its singular oblique. Why I put dash? There you have to add something to which, if we add the suffix k, we get the word putak, meaning to the sun. Put oblique is putta, you add k, it becomes putak, meaning to the sun. The plural oblique is putta. This is singular nominative form. This is singular oblique, and this is plural oblique. And by adding k suffix, we get putank, to the suns. See the difference between to the sun, putak, and putank in Konkani. English doesn't have this. English don't have suffixes adding like this. They have prepositions. Before the word you put to. To is a preposition in English. But Konkani doesn't have preposition. They have suffixes added to the oblique form of nominative words. Put become putta, then you say putak, and plural is putank. Okay. Don't worry, we'll soon see, and you will learn. In the following table, that means what I'm going to show you now, nouns are classified under genders. The first column gives the ending of noun, dash c ashet, means a noun ending in a consonant, dash letter a hachet means noun ending in vowel a, and so forth. This will be the convention in the following table. So now I need your full attention. This is the most difficult part of Konkani, most difficult part. So you have to understand properly. You have to learn it most of the time by heart, by memory. And then you can construct any number of sentences. Now first, nominative forms, oblique forms, endings. Ending in, this means ending in consonant. Take singular, put. Put is ending in a consonant, the. Plural of put is put only. To put, te put. Eklo put, dog put. Char put, char put. Doesn't change. Singular oblique is puta, and you have to put dash. That means you have to add something, suffix. A suffix has to be added to this. Puta by itself has a meaning, vocative. Puta means, oh my son. And plural oblique is puta. Puta. There is no meaning for this word. When you add a suffix, it gives you meaning. Like if you add k here, it becomes putank, means to the sons. So this is ending in a consonant. This is called pooth pattern. Then take this word, furnace.
Father, you said that putta means, oh my son.
Yes. And also the oblique form.
Yes. Singular. But if you have to say, oh my sons, how will you say it?
Putta.
Even plural. like to my sons? If you're calling out to many sons, oh my sons,
then that is a different word. That doesn't come under oblique form. This puta is a oblique singular, and it also means my son, oh my son.
Understood.
Okay. Then, now panas means jackfruit. Panas also ends in consonant, correct? Put is also ending in consonant. Panas is also ending in a consonant. But look at this and look at this. There is difference. Panas remains panas only. For us, no change. But look at the oblique form. What is happening? Pansa. Do you see a difference here and here? What is happening from panas to pansa? What change has taken place? Anybody? Look at this word, panas.
Vowel is added.
What
is added?
Pardon?
After double O goes.
That A has gone. The second vowel A is dropped in the oblique form. Because there are two vowels here. In the word Poot, there is only one vowel. So you cannot drop the vowel. Then you cannot pronounce it. But in Parnas, you drop the second vowel. This second vowel. A is dropped. So it becomes pansa. And plural oblique, just like this. Add N, pansa. Here there is no, this one, the change comes here. It dropped. Another word I'm giving. Kapus, cotton. Kapus. There is no plural for kapus. Kapus, kapus only. But what is happening here? Kapsa. What is the difference between this and this?
U.
U is missing.
And U. Vowel U is dropped. U. U is missing. I'm not saying U because I'm saying the Konkani. This is called in Konkani U. This is called in Konkani A. So kapus. The U vowel gets dropped here. And since there is no plural, there is no plural here. So, Poot is one pattern. Panas is one pattern. Kapus comes under this only, but there is a difference. There is no plural for that. Therefore, I have given. Take this one now. Undir. Undir. Some people will say Hundir, they will put H here also. It's okay, no problem. But for us, it is Hundir, means a rat.
Hundir.
Plural of Hundir is Hundir only. But here, something happens. What happens?
E sounding.
E sound is dropped. Hundir, it is not Hundira, it is Undra. And Undra, rat. So, Poot pattern, Panas pattern, Kapus pattern, Undir pattern. Then comes the word Manis. Manis means man. Also, it could mean woman. Huh? So, here I just put a man, does not mean woman is not there. Manis is a generic term. Manis. Man, woman.
Human.
Plural manis only.
Human being? Could it be human
being?
Yeah,
better to put human being. So let me put human being. That would be a better
person.
Human being.
What about person, Father? What do you call a person?
Yeah, person also.
Yes.
Human being. Manis. Right. But look at here. Look at here. It changes to Mansha, apostrophe, the N has to be pronounced, Mansha, because the S turns to Sh, Mansha, changes, and here Mansha, Here there is no difficulty, just add N. So Manish is a altogether another pattern. These are all different patterns, therefore they are put in different compartments. Next comes Der. Der, husband's brother. And this is Der, plural. Look at this. In traditional writing system, they don't make this distinction, so you don't know whether it is one or multiple. Here, very clear. Der, and Der, in the sense of brother-in-law. And its oblique is just like put, add a, there are, and there are. The difference comes only in the plural form, there, there. Otherwise, it follows the put pattern. I'm giving another example of this one only to get the correct. Pader, Pader, baker. One Pader, and this is Pader, plural. Padera and Padera. Sarop, Sarop, snake or cobra. And this is Sarop, plural. Becomes open, singular, closed, 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 open, open, open. And then see, look at this here. Sarpa, this second vowel is dropped. Here it is not dropped, but here it is dropped. And sarpa, so sarop is a another pattern. Further, reindeer, reindeer, toddy tapper, plural, reindeer. Then, reindeera and reindeera. All together. Now, this will be something like Pader, but Pader has got a, it is both are same pattern actually, but for you to give you very clear idea, although you may say how it is same pattern, here it is a and here it is closed a, therefore I kept as two separate patterns. Okay, it doesn't get dropped, here it gets dropped, Sarpa, but here it doesn't get dropped, it remains same. Reindeer, reindeer, Randera, Randera, toddy tapper. Next, this word you have come across. Chor, plural chor, oblique chora, chora. Just like put pattern. The difference is only here, singular is closed, chor and chor. Then it follows the put pattern only. Just add a and a and a. That's all. Look at this. Dongar, hill, plural, dongar, becomes open. Dongra, second vowel is dropped. So sometimes second vowel is dropped, sometimes second vowel is not dropped. So the question comes to your mind, when it is dropped and when it is retained? Can't say anything, therefore you must know this chart. Dongra and Dongra. These are all patterns. Masculine nouns and all ending in consonants. Remember that. This column is ending in consonant. Next pattern. Pai. Father. From Portuguese, this word came to us. Plural remains pai. Oblique is also pai only. And we don't use in the plural oblique, we don't use it. Pai. Pai ki use. To the father. Pai ka pai. Call your father. We have another word. Pine. Pine. Leg. Plural is pine only. Paya. Just like puta, you add a. To distinguish between this and this, I have given. Otherwise, this is put pattern. This is exactly like put. Ending in consonant remains same. Put, put remains put. Puta, puta. This also. Pai, pai, paya, paya. This is a altogether different pattern. Bapui. Bapui. Plural is bapui. Same. But oblique is bapai. Changing. This second vowel u becomes a. And then you add here bapai. This is altogether different pattern. Bapui, bapui, bapai, bapang. Awaz. I put asterisk. Why? We shall see down. Awaz. Plural awaz. But the second vowel doesn't get dropped. Awaza, awaza sound. Here also there are two vowels, one gets dropped, but here there are two vowels, the second one doesn't get dropped. Here there are two vowels, but it changes. U becomes A. So up to now, from top, let me go from here. This is consonant ending, same column. Put is one pattern. Panas is another pattern. Kapus, a sub pattern of this. Sub pattern of Panas. Only the difference is there is no plural, that's all. Undir is a pattern. One gets dropped, E gets dropped, and Undra it becomes. Manis is a pattern. It changes. Yes becomes sure. Mansha. There is a pattern. There is a pattern only in singular plural, not in the obliques. Oblique, it is like put pattern. There, there. Same way here. Padere, padere. Only in the plural, the difference.
Doctor? Padaran, Amutagire, Padaran, Poistilna, Padaran. Is it wrong? Padaran poist dilnay.
No, I can't say it is a colloquial form. Colloquial form, it is. We can't say it is wrong. No.
Okay. Yeah. Ani rendiru thesey rendran poist dilnay maga.
Yeah, correct. That means you are dropping that second vowel.
Yeah.
So it's correct. If you drop your second vowel, then it goes for you this undir pattern. In your dialect, yeah. Undir and Pader, they belong to one pattern because Undir second vowel is dropped, but here in the standard Konkani is not dropped.
Okay, Devarakun.
In the Bardeshi Konkani is not dropped. So you probably from Salset, am I right?
Yeah, I'm Salset.
Correct. Sasti. So yours will be go under this pattern. So it's not wrong.
Okay,
not at all. By no means. Because it follows a pattern. Okay? Yeah. Then render is a pattern. It doesn't get dropped. Renderan. Chor, only the singular plural, the difference. Otherwise, it is all like put pattern. Dongar and Dongor, once again, singular and plural. And also here, second vowel gets dropped. Pai. Nothing changes, remains pi only. I don't think so there are any other Konkani words belong to this pattern. Then pine. This follows like put pattern. Bapui is the only word of that kind. It has no other word as far as I know. Bapui, but bapai. It's a pattern. Then awaz. It doesn't get dropped. So these are all patterns for ending in consonants. See how many are there. I have given you a detailed table. Nobody, you will not find this table anywhere in the world. As far as I know, nobody has classified as I have done here. Yes.
How do you know when to use pai and when to use bapoi?
Pai to address. And bapoi is a reference term. Tokon, tomozo bapoi. You can say tomozo pai, but you don't call your father. When you address your father, you don't say bapoi. You say pai. Pai, anga bus.
Oh, okay.
There are address term. Bapu is a address, what you call reference term. And this is address term.
Okay.
Reference term is different from address term. Address means you are calling him.
Okay.
And this is you talk about him. Pai could be used both address term and reference term. Tokon, tomozo pai, you can say. Tokon tomozo bapui, but you cannot call your bapui is bapui. We say pai. Father. And now pai has gone and daddy has come. Papa is there, so many are there. That's a different story altogether. Okay?
Father. Is there anything like this for mother?
We will come. We are in the masculine, no?
Yeah.
We are like in the masculine gender, correct?
Like pai and
bapui. No. Wait. No. We will go systematically.
Okay.
Otherwise, we will be jumping from one tree to another tree. That I don't want. I want to that you get this. How difficult and it is difficult. Not to frighten you. It is difficult. Which word goes under which pattern?
Okay.
Very difficult. We need a good dictionary for this, which I'm working. Hope I live for another 5 years. Yeah, this is all for consonant endings. Now comes ending in A. Raza. Very simple. Raza. No problem. Here there is, we have only one pattern. No problem at all here. The difficulty is here. So many. Okay, then ending in E, Dudi pattern. Dudi means pumpkin. We have different types of pumpkin, don't worry about that. Now here pumpkin is a generic term, Dudi. Dudi, Dudi only. To Dudi, Te Dudi. Dudiya, Dudiya. See, I put Y, Dudiya in my writing system. Why? Dudiya. Then you take the word padri. I put star. Two asterisks I put. Why? Padri is from Portuguese word. Padre. Padri, Bahuvachan is padri, like Dudi. But it doesn't take this form. It's padri only. And padri. Padri kapai. Padrin kapai. But let me tell you, our Hindu brethren, they will say Padriya. And they are right. They are putting Padri in the Dudi pattern. So they are right. But Catholics do not say Padriya. Maybe some, I don't know, some people. But most of the people, I have not heard from Catholics. We say padri, pad, to padri, te padri, padrik, padrink. Therefore, dudi is a normal pattern ending in e, and there are few words like padri, they don't change. They remain padri only. Which are those words we shall see? Therefore, I put here two asterisk marks. We have to see what this means and what this means at the end. Then, ending in who? Ending in who? Natu, grandson. Natu remains Natu only, plural. But plural, look at it here, the oblique singular, Natva. That who becomes Va, Natva, and Natva, grandson. Regular, huh? Regular, there is no difficulty about it. Once you learn, like Dudi, Dudya, most of the words follow Dudi pattern, if they're ending in E, most of the words follow U, follow Natu pattern. But the next one, Guru, this is a borrowed word for us. Not borrowed, not now, at least centuries ago. Guru means teacher. Guru, plural means guru only. Its oblique is guru only. It doesn't become guruva. No. Guruk and guru.
Father, we cannot say shikopi.
That, see, shikopi is also teacher.
Yes.
Guru is not just shikopi.
Okay. Yes.
Guru could be a religious teacher.
Correct. Okay.
He's a religious leader.
Okay.
So this is something like, you know, guru is in this place, padri. Tomcho guru. Padri is a Portuguese word we have come.
Padri.
Guru is a religious leader. Could be.
Thank you, Father.
Okay. Then, ending in O. Ending in O. This word you know, ghado, ghade, oblique is ghadya. That A becomes ya and ya, horse. So, in masculine nouns, if singular ends in O, its plural is A, ghade. This is the only one rule could be given as far as masculine nouns are concerned in Konkani. Let me give few more words here. Redo. You heard about redo earlier from me. Redo means he buffalo. Redo, rede, redia, redian. And earlier in the text, you learned the word bokodo, correct? Bokodo, bokade, bokadya, bokadya. Earlier became the word combo. Combo, combe, combia, combia. We read the word pardo in the lesson earlier. Pardo, pade, padya, padya. Let me give one more word. Divo. Divo means light. D-I-V-O. Divo. Dive, divya, divya. So any noun, masculine, ending in O, is there. So it follows ghada pattern. Now, if you have any doubts about masculine nouns only, don't bring feminine and neuter, please ask. See this chart. Now, this is the difficulty with the online classes, which I, for me, first experience, and which I don't like online classes, because you can't teach properly. You don't know whether the students have understood, whether they can pronounce correctly. All this cannot be checked on online. But when you're offline, the students learn faster and correctly they learn. Anyhow, but the situation is different now. Sati. So you don't have the text before you. Therefore, it may be difficult for you. So let me take now. We started from Put. Slowly we went to Panas, Kapus, Undir. No rule could be given here because this is ending in consonant, this is ending in consonant, this end. So which pattern does it follow? Sometime it goes to Put pattern, sometime it goes to Panas pattern, sometimes to Kapus pattern, sometimes to Undir pattern. All are ending in consonant. Maybe Manish pattern, maybe their pattern. This Padher is same. Their pattern only it is. Maybe Sarop pattern because it gets dropped here. Padher and Render is same pattern. Maybe Chor pattern, maybe Dongar pattern because second vowels get dropped here. Pa is the only word. Pa is like Put only. Bapui is the only word in Konkani. Oh, Awas, second vowel doesn't get dropped. Then if it's ending in A and if it is masculine, it's this one. But we cannot say ending in A is always masculine. No, there are feminine words also ending in A. There are feminine words also ending in consonant. We will see that. You cannot say ending in E is masculine. No, there are feminine words also ending in E. So you don't know whether masculine or feminine. But if it is a masculine, then it has to follow this pattern or this pattern. If it's ending in A and it is masculine, it has to follow Raja pattern only. But ending in U, we have feminine nouns also ending in U. So rule cannot be given. But if it is a masculine, either it follows Natu pattern or Guru pattern. This is all for borrowed words. This is for native words. This is the only rule. Or blindly, in the sense, without any doubt, you can say Ghada pattern. And if you remember this Ghada pattern, all this Ghada, Ghade, Ghadya, Ghadya, any word masculine ending in O, you can put here. Any doubts?
Father?
Yes.
I still haven't figured out what the meaning of oblique form is.
Oblique form means before adding a suffix, the nominative form changes. You cannot say Dudik. You cannot say Natup. Can you? Okay. In Konkani, no. Therefore, Natwa is the oblique singular and Natwa is the oblique plural. You have to, in Konkani, for nouns, see, Latin and all, each of these forms have different, nominative different, accusative different, dative is different, agent is different. Like yesterday we did for pronouns, you remember?
Yes.
And locative and all. But for nouns, simple. That way, Konkani nouns have simple grammar. In the sense, you learn nominative and oblique and just go on adding suffixes.
But how do you know when to use nominative and when to use oblique?
For nouns, you need obliques.
Okay.
If you want to say to, on, you want to add any suffix, you have to add to the oblique form.
Okay.
See here. You go back. See, you go back to our text, and you will see how we have used what you call the oblique and all other things. I will show you here now. How there is. This is a pronoun, correct?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Which person? Which person?
First person.
First person. First singular. Hey. Which person?
Second person.
No. Third person.
Third person.
Plural. This is plural. What is this one? From how this becomes possessive, Maje. See, this is the possessive form. So the pronoun we have learnt, each of these forms we have learnt by heart. But in for this one, what you call nouns, you did not worry. But it's here, you see, we made duo plural, correct?
Yes.
Duo we made plural.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Now yes. Let me give you oblique form where we have used oblique form.
Father,
yes.
Can I just stop you for a minute?
Yes.
You are saying I have three daughters. Maka,
Tegi, Duo.
Tegi, Duo. Ahan, it should not be.
No need of verb. Tegi, Duo. Maka, Tegi, Duo. Asat, you can say at the moment.
Asat. That Asat has to come or not? Not necessary.
Not necessary. Somebody ask you a question. Tuka, Otumka, Kitlo, Duo. Maka, Tegi, Duo.
Okay.
In the conversation, there is no need of verb.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. See, now whoever question, I think that is Amelia asked me the question. Am I right? Who asked me the question about oblique, when to put oblique?
I asked.
Amelia, no?
No, I, Laura.
Laura. Madam Laura, look at here. Chat is a nominative word. X-E-T, chat is a nominative. Shata okay. Is the oblique. And NT means oblique, what you call locative form. You are going to learn Shatant. You cannot put Chat, you cannot put NT. You have to make oblique Chat become Shata.
Oh, okay.
Therefore, you have to learn singular, plural, oblique. You will learn. I mean, it is not that difficult. It is not that difficult here. See here, Bakadancho. See. Bokro, bok, yeah, bokadancho. This is
bokadancho.
Cho is the suffix. Cho is the suffix. Bokadan is the plural oblique of bokro.
Bokadan. Okay. Thank you, Father.
You cannot say bokrocho. You cannot say bokrocho or bokadancho. No. Bokadyacho or bokadyancho. This is the plural.
Yes. Okay.
Bokade, bokadya, and then cho is added. So oblique form is essential in Konkani.
Okay.
So you need not worry about so much of cases in as per nouns are concerned. Two cases only remember, nominative and oblique. Very simple. But those who are learning Portuguese, some of you are learning Portuguese or some of you may know Portuguese already, then you will know for put to add anything. You have altogether another form maybe, totally. But Konkani, for put, you cannot add K here. You have to say puta and then add K, puta.
Puta, okay.
Or putan.
Father,
yes,
if a masculine word is ending with E,
yes,
then does it have
ending in E like Dudi,
yes,
this one ending in E,
no, not I, E,
no, don't say I, this is Konkani E for me,
oh, okay. Yeah, okay, fine.
There is no noun ending in what you are meant to say, A.
We don't have.
Nominative singular, we don't have. See here, all my endings are very clear. Consonant ending, A ending, E ending, U ending, O ending.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Now you must say, like this only, not A ending. Don't say A ending. Confusing. A ending, E ending, Who ending?
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Yes. Now, that Awaz, I had put a singular one. You remember? Awaz, I had put a singular aesthetic here. That has been explained here. A few other words of this category are apar, pen nib. You know, now we don't have such pens. those who are using ink pen, formerly we are using ink pen, correct? And there were nib. That nib was called apar. And there are still people who use ink pens.
Doctor, then, apar is Portuguese word, no?
Huh?
Apar is Portuguese word?
I think so, yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Huh? So, that just follows this pattern. Apar, apar, apara, apara. That is the meaning. It follows that pattern. Or you take parvat, mountain. Parvat follows avas pattern. Parvat, parvat, parvata, parvata. Only few words I'm giving, not a whole list of words. Then vishay. Vishay means subject. Vishay, vishay, vishaya, vishaya. This common word, manai. Manai follows avas pattern. Manai, manaya, manaya. Then I gave this one, padri, two asterisk. Now two asterisk. Few other words of this category are adipati. Now these words have come to us in Konkani, written Konkani means king or boss. Mainly for boss, adipati. It follows just like padri, you know, same way, adipati, adipati, you know. Or kavi, poet. It doesn't follow dudi pattern. Kavi, you cannot make kavi, kavi, kavya, kavya. No. Now, no. Modern Konkani, no. So, adipati, kavi, senapati, commander of army, senapati. Rashtrapati, which is used in practically all languages in India, president of a country, or mestri, teacher.
Father, how does mestri become teacher?
Yeah, it's a Portuguese word.
Okay, okay, because sometimes mestri is referred to as a contractor.
Yeah. It has got many meanings, no? From teacher, we shifted like from our mom, no? Mama and mommy. From maternal uncle and auntie, we shifted to workers. Same way, mestri has gone from a teacher to a skilled worker.
Mestri is also our choir master in the church.
Beg pardon?
Choir master in the church.
Yes, mestri.
Mestri.
Tosto, Chikopinu, he's a music teacher.
But wouldn't it be maestro in the church?
Instructor.
Choir master, only maestro.
That is in Portuguese, maybe. For us, Konkani, mestri.
Mestri, okay.
Means teacher. It could have other meanings. I'm not giving all meanings here. I'm not writing a dictionary for you here. Here for me, for just to tell you, these words follow padri pattern. Is this clear? What I've said? These words follow avas pattern, apar, parvat, vishay, manai, and these words follow padri pattern. They're ending in he. And these are ending in consonant. Avas is ending in consonant. This is ending in r consonant. This is ending in t consonant, y consonant, y consonant. Then I put here three asterisks. Let us look at that. Few other words of this category are dhatu, metal. In written Konkani, we need this word, dhatu. Sadhu is a common word, sadhu. Sadhu, it doesn't become sadhva, no. Sadhu remains sadhu only. Or daku, dacoit, it also remains this pattern. And there are the words are there. These are not the only words I'm giving. Therefore, I said a few other words of this category, I said. So this is about masculine nouns, singular, plural, oblique singular, oblique plural, which you have learned. It is difficult, but still more difficulty is bound to come now, is going to come. This is difficult, but you see later on, other things are much more difficult than this. Any doubts you have here?
Father?
Yes.
The word Vishay you have given, no?
Yes, Vishay.
Does it mean subject in the school? Subject you want to
get? Yes, in the subject in the school, or you are giving a talk. So I can ask, tujhe ulopa to vishay kide?
Topic.
Correct, topic also.
Yes.
Because see, these words have come from, these are called pan-Indian terms. Means they are found in most of the Indian languages. This one, Adipati, Kavi, Senapati, Rashtrapati, okay, Sadhu, Daku, Dhatu. They are called pan-Indian words. From other languages, they have come to Konkani because we need these words. A common person doesn't need all this. But others, they need. Okay. No doubts. I will go further. Now we shall take feminine gender.
Father.
Yes.
Patiu and Padri with a difference. Kide? Patiu.
Ani?
Padri.
No difference.
We can
padri, padri is a reference term. Tokon, to padri. Patiu is a, sorry. No, this is a address term. Patiu is a address term. You don't speak to a priest. Oh, padri, you will say. No. It's a patiu. Tukko swasai. No?
Yeah, wait.
Patiu is a address term.
Yeah, okay.
And padri is a reference term. Tokon. Tomso padri.
Okay.
But patiu is both reference term and address term, just like bapui and pai.
Okay.
Father, how do you spell patiu?
Patiu. P. I mean, traditional system is different. I would write P-A-T-Y-U. Patiu. No doubt at all how to pronounce.
Okay.
P-A-T-Y-U. Patiu. Then, feminine nouns. Nominative forms, oblique forms, same. Ending, singular, plural, meaning. Ending in consonant. Rat, pattern. Night. Tirat. Tiorati. Oblique is rati only. And just add N, rati. Another pattern, ras, means heap. Ras, this become rashi, because actually it is rat pattern only, but si is not accepted in Konkani, I said, therefore si becomes x, correct? Sir becomes sure, so ras become rashi, and then it become rashi. The change takes place, si becomes xi, ras becomes rashi. Two patterns. Kale, and I put asterisk, we shall see why that one. Kale, plural keli, banana tree, and keli only, and keli. Third pattern. Pangat, plural pangti, second vowel is dropped. And pankti. This let me explain to you, because now this system has gone away. Earlier, weddings were taking place at home only. The reception was at home only. They would put a mato, pendal, in front of the house, and they would serve the meal. And the place is limited, so you cannot serve everybody. There was no buffet. meals were served. So you have different lot. The first set of people, first the guests were served, then village people, and last were the household people. So that pangat is called that one, people sitting in a row for a meal. This is still followed in our Hindu brethren. Now we go to halls. They book a hall and there is a buffet now. Even they also have a buffet system has come for them. But some simpler folk, you know, villagers, Hindus, they have the pangat system. First for the guests. If the wedding takes place in the bridegroom's place, the bride's people are first served, pahili pangat. Then the villagers, dusri pangat. And there could be tisri pangat of the household people. So that is called pangat. What is important is the second vowel is dropped. That is for me interesting. Look at this. Rat also ending in consonant. Ras is also ending in consonant. Kale is also ending in consonant. Pangat is also ending in consonant. But these four have one thing in common. Their plural becomes adding E, 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 E. Correct? Is this clear?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Now look at here. Look here very clearly. What? Way. Its plural become vato, closed. Here ending in E, here ending in O, vato. What? Vato. Vate, vatang. So, main two categories ending in consonant, feminine nouns belong to two main categories. Rat pattern and vat pattern. How to know? Learning by heart. What? Then, sub pattern of what? Khabar, news. Second vowel is dropped. Khabro. Khabre. Khabran. Kogul. Second vowel is dropped. Koglo. Kogle. Koglan. This is altogether slightly different. This is pat. Pat, open, tea pat, but plural is peto, closed, pete, peta, box. There, a gentleman asked a question like pie, do we have for mother? See here, awai, reference term, ti kon, ti maji awai, awai yo. But oblique is away only. This is the oblique. It doesn't follow this pattern. No, away. But here, awaya, it follows this pattern. Away is a pattern by itself. Worst. Worst thing. Plural become vastu. Vastu, vastu. This is the only word in Konkani of this pattern. Vast. Chao. No plural, but become chaye. Changes. This is the word all by itself. No other word follows this pattern. So, feminine nouns are much more complicated than masculine gender nouns. So, whether you are to follow this pattern, rat pattern, or what pattern, nothing. One must know. Therefore, we need a good dictionary. But in my book, you have no difficulty because all the nouns will be given its plural form, singular form, plural oblique, everything will be given. So, you did not worry about it. But other words, dictionary is required. A good dictionary, which we don't have at all.
Father,
and nobody thought about this.
Father, time up.
Time
we
up.
Are running late, yeah.
Yes. So, tomorrow is our last day. I will complete this one. And you may have some questions. I will answer your questions. And tomorrow, we can extend our class a little bit because I need a little feedback, not the method of teaching, because I'm not going to teach henceforth because my lifespan is very little. I want to spend my rest of my life for creating material, which nobody will prepare if I don't prepare. I know that. So I want to prepare material and get it published if I'm alive. That is my main concern now. So any suggestions about this method of presentation, not teaching, but that the way I've given example, this way, every word I've given meaning, or you find something else is missing, something else is needed. So your any suggestions you have regarding the matter, you please tell me, so that helps me to improve the textbook. So my whole concern would be the textbook for basic Konkani. So,
Father, instead of making it a little late, can we start a little early? Because at 9 o'clock we have Father Richard's talk.
Okay. So, shall we start 6 o'clock tomorrow?
Yes, yes, Father.
Okay.
Yes, yes. Good.
Thank you. So, first we will do this. And last 5 minutes, for me more than enough, you give me your suggestions. And sincere suggestion. See, I don't want your praises and or something. Please don't waste your time. I don't want all those things. Oh, your class was very good, that good, and all that. I'm not interested. I'm interested in the subject matter, how to improve what I've given. Is this sufficiently my writing system which I proposed? Do you find it is easy to read? How do you find reading? You may not know the meaning, but can you read? Is it easy enough or difficult or what? So, on that. And all
Father,
this, yes.
If you give us a paragraph to read, like you gave us those sentences, my name is Edwin Kalasko. I have three sons. If you give us a paragraph to read, then we may be able to read that.
Yeah, that's what I see.
Yeah, you gave today, that paragraph.
Today, because all these days I was teaching you the bare minimum. But henceforth means my book will have this form. Like this. First, there will be a text. First, it will have teaching points. Then it will have the text. And then comes the grammar. And then comes the exercise, which you have not done. See, we will be doing tomorrow. We have so many exercises to be done. I'll show you here. After all, see, these are all exercises we have to do tomorrow.
Okay, Father.
All this we have to do. So many are there.
Father, tomorrow is our last class eventually, right?
Yeah, last class. Yes, yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm reading this Nova Korar, Father, which I picked from Porvori, your institute, which Konkani is very simple. Nova Korar.
From our institute, Nova Korar, we have not published.
No, but it was available there when I went there. So I picked up a free copy, which was on the desk there. So many were there, the blue cover.
I see.
Yeah, very, very simple Konkani. It is written by this the Gideon's International.
So that means it's a different one then.
I don't know. I picked it up from the Jesuit house.
At Parvari Konkani Kendra?
Yes, yes, yes.
TSKK, Thomas Stevens Konkani Kendra?
Thomas Stevens Konkani Kendra, yes.
So that must be of the, not of the diocesan publication then.
Okay, yeah, yeah. But
I have not seen.
But the Konkani is very simple, Father, written there.
I see.
Whatever you have some put. Like sun and everything is there.
I see. Maybe. Yeah. I have not seen it. Maybe a Protestant
edition, could be.
Maybe a Protestant. I'm not very sure.
Yes. Yes,
yes, yes, Father. Gideon is Protestant. They have the Gideon Bible in every hotel.
Ah, okay. That's okay. There's no problem about it. You can learn the language at least.
Yeah, what I liked is the language is very simple. It's a written Goan language.
Yeah.
Thank you, Father.
Yeah.
Father, we won't get this file today.
No, because this is not yet completed.
Okay.
We are not completed this. Okay. There's no point in sending you this file first.
Okay.
Or maybe what I'll do, I will try to this one, maybe tomorrow, some morning, I will try to send the whole file to Savio, and Savio can forward it. So you have some time to go through it.
Yes.
That may be better.
Or you can, Savio can also truncate the file. Whatever we have done till today, he can, from PDF, you can take that out. You can split it into two.
No, the entire file, I will go through once again. There may be some mistakes, spelling, whatever. I will go through, and tomorrow morning, I will send to Savio, and Savio will then forward it to you. So at least you will have 1 or 2 hours before the class to go through, so that whatever questions you have, you can, based on that, you can ask.
Okay. Thank you, Father.
Yeah. Bare. Dev bare karu.
Dev bare.
Tumkai karu.
Tumkai.
Dev bare karu.
Dev bare karu.
Yeah.
Mogasu.
Mogasu.
Mogasu.